What is up, guys? Welcome to the second episode of The Beholder. And The Beholder is a title I got from the quote, "Beauty is in the eye of the beholder." So this whole series is about you seeing yourself as God sees you and you seeing yourself as beautiful. So for this chapter, if you haven't watched my first video, the first video will be in the link down below. So you should definitely check that out and then come back to this one. So this chapter two, I'm going through the chapters. This is the book I'm reading again, Hello Beautiful. And so this is what this series is about. So for chapter two, episode two, it's all about not me. So what not me means is that when you receive compliments like, oh, you look really pretty today, but you have your hair up, you have no makeup on, and you're wearing like sweatpants, it's you being like, not me. Like, are you kidding me? Like, I'm not pretty. Like, I'm not beautiful today. I need my makeup on, I need my hair done, I need my clothes to be nice. What chapter two is about is getting past the not me phase. So not me also from a Christian perspective would be when you feel that God forgives everybody who sins except you, when you think that you have such a bad past that you can't be forgiven. I think everybody has gone through some rough times, whether they admit it or not. I think everybody has face some trials and tribulations where they believe that they really might not be forgiven from them. And so you would be thinking, not me, like I'm not forgiven. And so this whole chapter is about moving past that. And so when you say not me, that's the doubt coming from the hiss, which is the first episode of the series. And so it puts a fear in your mind, a fear of failing, a fear of not being enough, a fear of not being liked, and a fear of being out of control. When you're receiving a compliment and you say, not me, you're basically saying that you're not good enough to receive the compliment, and sometimes that even leads to comparisons. That would be comparisons like some people say, your channel has really good content, I like your videos. And I'll say, not my channel, like, are you kidding me? There's so many other channels out there, like Nikki Blackheader, Heidi Sommers, all those big names out there. And I'm like, not my channel. My channel doesn't mean anything compared to theirs. And so for me to work past that, I have to see my channel as a separate thing. I'm not as advanced as they are because I am still learning and growing. They're still learning and growing. I'm in chapter one and they're in chapter 20, you know? Like that quote says, don't compare your chapter one to somebody else's chapter 20. And so I'm still in chapter one. I'm still learning and growing and trying to eat healthy, trying to, you know, balance out school and health and nutrition and fitness and it's just hard for me to do it all right now. And so when people compliment my channel, I'm always like, not mine. Like, I don't know why I'm even doing this. But then I realize that I'm doing this for myself. And so to get past your not me phase is basically that you need to start realizing, opening your eyes and realizing that you are important. You have a place in this world and that everybody's made uniquely. Nobody in this world is the same person. Nobody goes through the exact same things in life. And so what you do to get past the not me phase is just to, you have to realize that you're special and important. This may be a short lesson, I guess you could say, but I wanted to share that with you guys, so that's what I have for today. So next time, just accept the compliments because you are worthy of them, and don't forget that you are beautiful. Now we will go to my lower body day. By the way, this lower body day is very interesting. I tried all these new exercises that I have never done before. Except the glute exercises, I've done those. But all the other exercises, I tried this weird equipment that they have in my gym at the rec center. And so I hope you guys enjoy it and leave a comment down below. Let me know what you guys think about this series and this video. And I will talk to you guys at the end of the video.
Just. Can't break rules with a break beat. And I'll break bread up in the back seat. And if they cut checks, I'ma cash these. I'm gonna marry Kate and Ashley's. Got a full house coming with a full deck. Sipping on the ace of spades and I ain't fold yet. No, never. And I'm all in. My phone rings. She calling. Now she Alex Trebek and me questions. Beckin' me questions. Beckin' me questions. Beckin' me, beckin' me, beckin' me questions. Trebek doesn't ask any questions. The roof is on fire. We don't care who sparked the flame. Can't take this roof any higher.
So we just light it up and burn it just to watch it blaze. Been heating up all day, stuck in this inferno, straight cooking al dente. Money is the appetizer, spending is the entree. Big room house, fill the basement and the hallway. She, Alex Trebek, and me questions, beckin' me questions, beckin' me questions, beckin' me, beckin' me, beckin' me questions. Trebek doesn't ask any questions. The roof is on fire, we ain't gone nowhere. The roof is on fire, 'cause you know we don't. What's up with your team? Tell your girls they can come kick it with us.
It's loose.
I'm willing to bet. Time flies if you in there with Callum Rest. Doing my dance and I'm going dumb.